you on speaker, Art.
Well, I just don't want to...
Thank you.
That's mine.
Think I'm ready to go?
Tim, pretty quick, just a minute.
Okay.
I'm trying to...
Thank you for still watching.
What? Yeah, she said she thought there was long enough around to have a...
Minutes.
I don't have one.
Is Jim not here?
Minutes. Minutes for this meeting. We're supposed to be delivering the minutes for the meeting, the last meeting.
Oh, is that on the agenda?
Yep. Approval of minutes of meeting on August 20th.
Well, we can either allow me time to go get them, because I didn't know that, or we can skip it. Which would you rather?
I would put it off at this time. Just have them in front of us voting this approval, since we have to read it first and make sure they're correct. We wouldn't want to take the time now to read it. Please come to order. The Board of Directors for the Quartzsite Special Projects Incorporated are now in session. Would the clerk please call the roll?
President Simpson.
Here.
Vice President Ferguson.
Vice President Ferguson.
There we are.
Hi, Jim. We're just doing roll call.
We're doing roll call now. Jim, turn.
I'm here.
Okay.
Secretary Treasurer Warner.
Here.
Director Tanell.
Here.
Okay, item one, business. Approval of the minutes of the meeting of August 28th, 2019. We have not received a copy of those to be able to study and verify that they're a correct copy. So we'll put that item off until our next meeting.
Very good.
Item number two, discussion of procurement process. Would you... Would you explain the process so we have it on the record?
Okay. What I wanted to go over with the procurement process was just the way that we go about purchasing, what and how, who does the purchasing, how checks are written, and that type of thing, so everybody's clear about how that works. First of all, every purchase request must have a purchase order. There are times when a purchase order needs to be made after the actual purchase. And an example of that would be, like, for instance, if we buy something on the internet, like the banners or whatever, we don't always know exactly how much it's going to be before. So we could do a purchase order that says not to exceed or, you know, to be determined, but if we make the purchase order after the purchase is made, the purchase has to have been approved by the committee. The committee for, in this case, Bud Connors. So those of the folks that do the committee work say this is what we're going to be needing, like rec cards and banners and that type of thing. And then the purchase orders, the person from that committee that's assigned to do the purchasing, like for instance, the banners. Mark Goldberg was doing the banners because he gets a discounted rate on those banners because of his association through his off-road. So even though he's buying them for the Buck Connors event, he's using his relationship from the off-road to be able to get discounts and so forth. So in that case, the purchase order would be actually written after we have the amount that's in there. We have a budgeted amount of how much those banners are supposed to run. So he knows not to go over that amount.
Right.
Okay, and then the purchase order has to be signed by a requester. And in some case, it's the town, the committee itself that is doing the requesting. And other times, it's signed by an individual like me or Sharon or somebody. If we know what the, if it's a certain person that's filling out the purchase order. If it's something that's been approved by the committee, we can use the committee as the requester. And then the each purchase order needs to be signed by somebody authorizing it. And typically, right now, the person that does most of the signing is Jim, because he's not a signer on the checks, so it's okay for him to be a signer on the purchase orders. There are a few exceptions. For instance, I signed one for $53 for the little square thing because it came across my desk and he was unavailable. So in rare occasions does someone else sign that. I prefer not to be the one to sign it because I am a signer on the bank account and I think that it needs to be somebody different. Okay, when the purchase orders are signed and put into the system for processing, if a check is cut, then right now there are three of us that are authorized to sign checks, and that's myself, President Simpson, and Director Tunnel. Anyway, but two of the three of us have to sign each check before it goes out. I'm sorry?
He's agreed.
Okay. The other thing is that there is a debit card that is associated with the bank account, and there is one debit card, and right now the treasurer is holding the physical card. However, because we do procurement through the town finance department, under the direction of the finance director for some things, for instance, the children's corral, there's some things that are being purchased on the internet for the children's corral. The finance department is actually doing that because they have a relationship with those people. Again, sometimes we can get discounts. They have the time to do the research, and they are here interfacing with the people that have the need. So that procurement is actually made with somebody in the finance department under the direction of the finance director. And that person has access to the card number so that they can make online purchases. That card is not to be used for anything except online purchases of items that have been approved by the committee. And it doesn't have to say, we're going to buy 14 balloons. You know, when they say that they're going to buy, you know, children's corral items, that's what I mean by approval. I don't mean every individual item, right, line items, because we don't always know what those are when we're in committee. And sometimes if the committee would do it that way, it may have to change because you could find something to substitute. So that's why it's a little more generic, but still it cannot be used for anything except procurement of online, or unless there's some kind of communication with the finance director and the treasurer to get approval for a different kind of expenditure other than an online purchase. The only other person that would have access to that number would be somebody that is authorized by the committee to purchase that something that the finance department doesn't do. For example, Mark Goldberg, when he purchases the banners, he had access to the number long enough to purchase the banners, and he's not to purchase anything else with that card, and he knows that, except the things that he is authorized to purchase. So I think right now he's purchased rack cards and banners. Again, it's because of his relationship with those vendors that we do allow him to do that because he gets discounts for it. So that's it.
Any questions from the board?
Were we going to have any limitation to where it come back to the committee to approve a purchase over a certain dollar amount?
My understanding is that the limit is $1,000. If there's a anything over $1,000, it has to come before the committee before the purchase is made. And so far, the only thing that I know of that has been over $1,000 was Dr. Montgomery, and we approved him way up front, so. But everything else has been well under the $1,000 limit.
Is this a copy or correct process that we use that would be specified elsewhere? Would it be in our bylaws or constitution?
No, not at this time.
Okay. Any other questions? As this is a new organization and we're trying to acquaint the community with it also, is there any community members that wish to ask a question?
Thank you. I'm used to calling you mayor.
President.
President. I have a question. You said it takes two signers on a check. So, obviously, there's only two of the gyms, not a signer. So, and Kiki is. So, will one of you two just come down here and sign the check, or how's it? Is there a delay then?
Well, yeah, there usually is because we're both not at the same place at the same time. So, but I try to get, Norman is also a signer. So between me, Kiki and Norman can sign, Norman and I can sign, or Kiki and I can sign. So typically I sign it because I cut the check and then I find one of the other two. And I try to do it within 24 hours.
Okay.
So that it gets out in a timely manner.
There's not a huge delay.
No. And usually it's the same day if I can
manage it.
Yeah. He's a little more mobile, so I usually try to get him to be the second signer because then that way I always have the purchase order attached to the check, so if there's any question about the purchase order, they can review the purchase order and then the check is attached to that.
But there's checks and balances.
Absolutely. I never sign anything on my own, so it's gonna always be someone else.
Getting a little feedback here somewhere, but
it's actually my backup keeper on my car.
Okay.
Sorry.
This requiring two check signers is one of our own systems of checks and balances. The bank is not obligated to enforce that, but any one of us involved sees a check go out with one signature, they raise questions. That's our own internal system for checks and balances. Make sure everything is kept correct.
Well, when the checks were purchased, it was, there are two lines
okay.
for the signatures, so there's no question that there should be two signers.
But the bank won't enforce it if?
No, that's not their policy. It's too much for them to just, for every company, whether or not they need one signature or two, so they don't enforce it.
Anyone else? Any other questions? Okay, we'll bring it back up. Final discussion here. This is not an action item. This is a discussion, information, let's see, Vice President Ferguson, do you have any questions on this?
No, I think it's a good process. It does have the proper checks and balances all the way through. Especially with me not signing any checks, I can, you know, sign the purchase order itself or prove it, that is.
Okay. Nothing else, no action required on that item. We'll move on to item three. Discussion and possible action on the budget for Buck Connor State. And I don't have in front of me a copy of the proposed budget.
I called earlier and asked, and Jennifer told me you have a copy of that budget.
Kiki emailed me a copy, but I didn't know I was supposed to make copies. I'll make copies right now.
So while she's doing that, we can go on to number four, the approval of the purchase orders.
Okay, while she's doing that, we can
move on to item four, approval of purchase order. Okay, this list of...
Well, I've had some purchase orders, and I got a hold of Jim yesterday for some approvals. And I just kind of... There's one purchase order I know that's going to be outstanding for somewhere between $250 and $300 for the kids' area. Is that correct?
No, I have two of them right here.
Okay. So I just haven't gotten those yet. And then we paid half to Dr. Buck, so we paid him $21.25 out of the $42.50 that we owe. And the others that we've done so far were for banners. We've got outstanding purchase orders right now for all of the musicians that we have coming to the, because we're not going to be paying those until the day of the event, but we have purchase orders sitting out there so that we know how much all of that's going to be, with the exception of Dr. Buck, and we did pay him half up front at his request. And that's in the, that check has been written and is in the mail. The only other things that we've done were banners and rack cards. What we have yet to do that I know of besides the kids is the business license for the town of Quartzsite. We need to buy a business license.
Oh, thanks for getting
it. And those are, and then Sharon, you've got some, is that all children's?
Yes.
Okay. All right. So those are the purchase orders that we have outstanding at the moment. I'm sure there will be others, but right now that's all we have.
He's driving.
Okay, so that is a kind of a breakdown of...
Sorry about that.
No worries.
That's what the breakdown is of the purchase orders that we've had so far.
Yes, okay.
Okay, this is an action item. Any questions on this item?
No. And the only item, and the only purchase orders that I know of that are outstanding that need to be approved are the two that Sharon has and the one for the business license that I need to create. Yet.
Okay, this is an action item.
It's just that we just approved it. I mean, Jim is the one that approves the purchase order, so.
Okay.
You know, he does not have to be the one to approve them. And since he's not here,
he
approved them. Okay, so those are approved. The only one that's not approved yet is the business license, and we'll deal with that when he gets back. Okay.
So, just information then.
You have to ask the town manager that question.
What was that question?
He wanted to know why we don't waive that fee. We, the town of Quartzsite, don't waive the fee for a business license.
For a town event put on by the town, it makes no sense for the town to have to buy a business license for the town.
Well, it's not really for the event. The business license is actually for the special projects entity.
Oh, okay.
Right.
Okay, so this is not really requiring a motion or approval then. It's not an action item, it's an informational item.
Correct.
Okay, we have in front of us the budget, tentative budget for item shown in item three. So let's just look that over.
What it does show in this in the budget is advertising. You've got vendor applications, Buck Connor event contributions, like for instance when the chili cook-off gives us X amount of percentage of their net revenue, and then any kind of interest income that we get from the bank, which is really minimal. But those are the kinds of income that we have on this budget. The things we have in expenses are advertising and marketing, like newspaper ads, white sheet, social media advertising, banners, rack cards, that type of thing. And then business license and permits. We have office supplies. We have a little bit in there for office supplies for ink and paper and that type of thing, postage and shipping if we have any need for that. Typically, the shipping, that comes in when we are buying something on the internet and they charge us shipping charges. That's where the shipping comes from. Event entertainment, that has to do with either musical, that's broken down into music entertainment and non-music. Non-music would be like fun jumpers. There's a clown, Tickles, I think, the clown. They definitely are not musical, so we put them in a non-musical entertainment. And then the children's games and so forth. Trophies, if we're going to be giving out trophies for the UTV event or the chili cook-off, that's what that's for. And then venue, expenses would be like the sanitary facilities, lighting, heating, you know, and when we have to pay the off-duty police officers for security, that's what the security expense is. Bank charges and merchant fees, that one has to do with the use of the square or whenever somebody uses a credit card, and also if Horizon Community charges us any bank fees for use of their. The one at the bottom, the other income, there's two line items down there. There's an in-kind contribution and an in-kind expense. And what that does, and this is the way that you report the value of something that has been given to you that is not monetary. For example, when KPUX does a regular spot for us, that spot has a value. And so we put it in as an income, and then we take it back out as an expense because he gave it to us, but we gave it back to him. So that's why it's in there that way. And there's an in-kind, like I said, an in-kind contribution and an in-kind expense. So if there are any questions about that?
Yeah, page 2, bottom line, shows our net income is negative $2,775. Is that the proposed start?
Well, some of that is because up in the, this one is based on what we've currently gotten. It doesn't have what's coming up. So this came off of a proper, basically an income and expense that went against the budget. So your budget amount is on, if your annual budget is on the right and your expense and so forth is on the left. And it's income that we've gotten so far and expenses and the budget that we are anticipating. The reason that number is low like that is because we don't always know what's coming in on the income yet. So that will change as the January through September numbers get bigger, as we get contributions and so forth. Those numbers down at the bottom are going to change.
Okay. If this is a standard format you use, mm-hmm. we need to change the expense to expense. If this is on your template, it's worth correcting. So just to print out occasional things.
Because on mine is right.
Okay. You've already corrected.
Yeah, caught it.
Okay. Discussion we've had, and we're looking, it says, at possible action. Are we adopting a budget?
I'm not sure it's appropriate to adopt this budget at this meeting. I think we need to have at least one more meeting of the committee before we adopt a budget. primarily because we're still kind of figuring out what we're doing. So, but this was just to kind of give you an idea of what it was that we're looking at for income and expenses. So I think before we adopt a budget, we need to have at least one more committee meeting, which should be Thursday of this week.
I agree with that. I think we've got a few things that we need to finish up, but we should be able to get that done in the next week.
What date are you proposing?
The committee meeting is tomorrow at 10, and I think if we need to finalize or approve this budget as a board, then we can meet one day next week or towards the end of next week.
Excuse me, has this meeting for tomorrow gone out to you in something that, in this format?
No, no, the meeting for tomorrow is the committee meeting for Buck Connors. It's a standard 10 o'clock.
Oh, okay.
So.
It's not a special projects meeting, okay. It's a committee meeting. But that committee is who feeds us this budget.
And we will be good to go. Jim, you think for tomorrow to set up a meeting for next week for the special projects to adopt a budget?
Oh, I sure hope so. After last week's meeting, there were very few loose ends, which should be finished up tomorrow if everybody's got their figures together as they're supposed to.
Okay, well, and one of the things that I want to make very clear to everybody on the board and in the public, when you put together a budget, that does not necessarily mean that's how much money you have to spend. What that is a guideline so that you know how much money there is available and where it can be spent. So if you go over the budget, because some people think that you adjust the budget so that it matches actual. And that's not the way a budget works. If you budget $100 and you spend $105, you're $5 over budget. If you've got a $100 budget and you spend $95, you're $5 under budget. But that budget number stays the same. So when we adopt a budget, what we're adopting is the guideline for what the procurement people, what they use for procurement purposes. Now, that doesn't mean that they can't go over a little bit if they have to because of shipping or whatever, but they certainly don't want them to go over, but they can certainly stay under the budget. So I just wanted to make sure that everybody knew that the budget is not going to be adjusted so that it reflects what is actual. There will be a separate column that is the actual versus what was budgeted. And then there is a percentage of that is over and under. Or a dollar amount that's over and under. Personally, I prefer a dollar amount over and under, and it can be displayed either way. I like the dollar amount because I think that makes more sense to people than percentages.
Okay. To make sure everyone is clear, the committee will meet tomorrow, and the action from that will be put on an agenda for next week's meeting.
For the special projects
meeting,
right. Yes.
And at that time, tentatively, we'll adopt a budget.
That's correct.
Okay. Is that clear to everybody, anyone in the audience?
I just want to make sure that you guys know that the budget that we're approving is the Bud Connors budget. It is not a special projects budget. Bud Connors is a part of special projects, but it's not the overall special projects budget.
Good explanation. Okay, we'll move on to item 5, future agenda items. Anything that we need to...
The approval of the budget and also the approved minutes.
Okay, I'd like for us to consider applicants for the vacant position as well.
That would be good.
Okay, anything to add to that, Vice President?
No, I think that would be fine. Those are the most important ones right now.
other than what we've missed? Hearing none, we have no further business to come before this board. We're hereby adjourned.
Thank you, Jim.
Thanks, Jim.
Thank you.
Thanks, Tina.